Hey everybody, happy Thursday to you. I'm glad that you've joined me here today. It is another edition of 5 Minutes with Phil, and I'm thrilled that you've joined me here today. We are going to talk about our prayers that we offer to God. What should we do to pray? I have heard a lot of different teachings on how to pray and how to get your blessing and how to get the answer that you're looking for. And there's a lot of well-meaning people that will say, well, you got to use this word and that word, and you got to do this, or you got to pray this long or that long, or you got to pray at this time or that time, or you got to pray this many times during the day, and then you'll get your answer. And to be honest with you, oh man, I think we sometimes make spiritual things harder than what Jesus intended them to be. I really do. And I want to share from the book of Hebrews today, from the 11th chapter, verse 6. Take a look at the screen. Here's what it says. And without faith, it is impossible to please God, because anyone who comes to him must believe that he exists and that he rewards those who earnestly seek him. Now, having faith in God in some circles of Christianity has really been, that term has been kind of abused over the years, where we almost equate having faith with commanding God to do this, and he is somehow compelled to do my bidding because I'm kind of working myself in this spiritual faith lather and just, here we go, and Give me what I want. And that's not how it works. It's not how it works. Without faith, it's impossible to please God. So what is that? That is me having a trust in God that maybe doesn't make sense. It's beyond my human comprehension. It's beyond my human capabilities. If I pray for God to heal somebody of cancer, all right, I can't do that. I'm trusting God to do something that is beyond me. And maybe it's even beyond other people or beyond doctors or beyond surgeons. And I've got this faith that says, God, I believe you can do it. I believe, Lord God, that you're able to do it. That's having faith in God. And we believe that he exists. We believe that he is, one version says. But we believe that God exists. Now, what do we mean by that? I think sometimes, and we talked about this earlier in the week, right? I think sometimes we feel like God is somehow absent from our lives. And God is somehow absent from our situation. And maybe we're at a low point where we feel like maybe God's abandoned us or something like that. And I think we need to remind ourselves, and we need to be reminded, that God is still there and that he exists in my situation and he exists in your situation. He has not left me. In fact, the Bible says that he'll never leave me and he'll never forsake me. And then we're told that we should remember that he is a rewarder of those who earnestly seek him. I love that. God rewards people who seek them with their whole hearts, another scripture says. And I grew up at a time, I'm 54 years old right now, and I grew up at a time where the generation and the generation above that, older than me, man, they knew how to pray. They would pray so hard. And I think there's part of us sometimes, we just kind of give God this flippant prayer and we say, okay, whatever. But I think God wants to take us to a point where we say, Lord, I'm going to press in. I'm going to depend on you. I'm going to trust you with everything. And God, I refuse to stop praying until I see an answer. I'll say that again. I refuse to stop praying until I see an answer. Today, when you pray, I want you to have a trust and faith in God. If there's something that's heavy on your heart, believe that He can do something about it. Believe that He's there with you. He's right there with you. And He will reward those who earnestly, passionately, wholeheartedly seek Him. I want you to be encouraged by that today. Okay, gonna let you go. Thanks. Have a great day. We'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.